The Warning Signs of Disk Failure, an unexpected tale of gradual decline and urgent replacement. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. A couple of days ago, I shared with you a video, lengthy video actually, of what I went through when I reformatted and reinstalled my primary desktop machine, why I did it, how I did it, and all the software that I ended up installing after I did it. One of the things I alluded to, though, was that there was a problem that this process uncovered. I want to talk about that today. One of the reasons I elected to reinstall Windows was what I perceived to be a gradual slowdown. Basically, the machine just wasn't as peppy as it used to be, which is kind of sort of normal for machines that have been around for a while. A reformat reinstall usually deals with that relatively well. The other thing, though, that had been happening is that after basically 3.5 years worth of pretty solid operation, I think I'd seen only one blue screen in that entire time, I had, in the weeks leading up to all this, 2 or 3 blue screens, which was unusual. And it just sort of pushed me over the edge to say, you know what? It's time. It's just time for me to do this. So I reformatted and reinstalled. After the installation, the system actually seemed pretty peppy in general, with one exception. And that was a specific hard drive. The E hard drive, which was an 8 terabyte internal hard drive on which I had placed my OneDrive, my Dropbox, my other cloud storage providers. When I installed OneDrive, it began to re-index the existing collection of OneDrive files. That took a while. What I didn't realize is that it shouldn't have taken quite as long as it did. The drive was just slow. When I reinstalled Dropbox, I mentioned in that prior video that it was frustrating and I ended up throwing up my hands and just letting Dropbox download the entire 2.7 terabytes that I have stored in Dropbox. In theory, that should have been, I won't say quick, it would have taken a theoretically fastest operation would have taken 6 hours, which wasn't going to happen. Acceptable would have been 10. Heck, I would have been happy with 12 hours. But as I watched it progress, it looked like it was going to take on the order of several days. And it did. That ain't right. That wasn't supposed to be happening. But things got worse. It took me a little while to put two and two together. But the bottom line was that every time I accessed that E drive, whatever I was trying to do would take a really long time, as in multiple seconds before it would come back to me. Initially, I assumed this was because OneDrive was hitting the disk and Dropbox was hitting the disk. But honestly, even if those two are hitting the disk, even hard, there shouldn't be that kind of lag between my wanting to do something and my seeing some results of doing that something. So I got suspicious, especially after blue screens would happen in some cases, and each case involved accessing that hard drive. I said, you know what? Rather than trying to diagnose the heck out of this thing, I'm going to take the other route, what I call the pragmatic route. These drives aren't that expensive these days. And I just went to Amazon and hit buy now on a replacement 8 terabyte hard drive. When that came in, I shut down my machine, of course, opened up that machine and took out the old, potentially failing hard drive and replaced it with this new empty hard drive. When I fired up Windows again, I had to use Disk Manager, of course, to initialize that drive, but the net result was I had this new 8 terabyte completely empty hard drive in my machine. I took the old hard drive and connected it to a USB to SATA adapter, essentially, that allowed me to treat it as an external hard drive. Fortunately, the drive was working. I could still read from it, maybe slowly, I wasn't sure, but I had this opportunity to copy everything from that hard drive to its replacement. I elected to do that using the command line. So just for completeness sake, the command line operation that I ended up using, if F was the old drive, the failing now external drive, and E was its replacement internal drive, the command I used was xcopy space /F:/E:/D:/E:/C:/H. So that copies everything from F to E. /D copies only files that don't already exist. Yes, I know it's an empty drive, so theoretically nothing would exist. But if for whatever reason it got interrupted, this same command would basically pick up where it had left off. /E means copy all subdirectories or folders, everything in them, and even empty folders. /C means ignore any errors that you might encounter along the way. And then /H means also copy any hidden files. Several hours later, I had everything copied. I rehooked up Dropbox. I rehooked up OneDrive to these locations. And while both of them took some time to, again, reindex or reinitialize, nothing had to be redownloaded. The 2.7 terabytes that were on the drive, they were on the drive, didn't have to get them again. The half a terabyte that was in OneDrive, they were there. All it had to do was spend a fair amount of time, Dropbox does take a while to do this, but a fair amount of time just reindexing. And once it was done, it then caught up with any changes that had happened in the meantime. So it meant it downloaded a few files and maybe uploaded a couple. But the bottom line is, it was done. And as I record this, they're both working quietly in the background just fine. And in fact, Dropbox is how this video will make its way from my machine to the machine of my editor and back. So that's where we're at. Things seem to be operating normally once again. Still to come on this drive, I haven't yet hooked up Google Drive, which I use. I yesterday updated and reconnected Proton Drive, which was small. It wasn't that big, but that, again, worked out just fine. And things, like I said, just seem to be working. The point of all this is to give you an example of a scenario that doesn't necessarily have an obvious cause. There were multiple clues that basically led me to suspect. I couldn't really even point a finger when I replaced the hard drive and said, yes, this is the problem. But everything was kind of sort of leading me in that direction. And now you get a kind of a sense for the kinds of things that you might consider when you're encountering problems like this as well. Replacing an internal hard drive, that may or may not be something that's in your wheelhouse. That's fine. There are people that will do that. It's not that hard. But it can be a great solution to various kinds of problems, like what I ended up experiencing. And the old hard drive, once I'm satisfied that things truly are well and done, I'll probably take that old hard drive and run checkdisk/R on it for however long it takes and see if that hard drive actually had what I would consider to be a soft failure, something that's recoverable, or a hard failure, at which point it's time to drill a few holes through it and recycle the electronics. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/170689. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.